Connor. I thought you might enjoy a little cruise.
Yeah.
This place. Everything is so calm and peaceful. Far from the noise of the world. Tell me, what have you discovered?
I found two deviants at the Eden Club. I hoped to learn something, but I had to destroy them.
You seem lost, Connor. Lost and perturbed.
Perturbed? No. No, of course not. Why would I be perturbed?
If your investigation doesn't make progress soon, I may have to replace you, Connor.
Understand.
Something's happening. Something serious. Hurry, Connor. Time is running out.
Poor Connor.
You're starting to piss me off with that coin, Connor.
Sorry, Lieutenant.
Hi, Hank.
Shit, what's going on here? There was a party and nobody told me about it?
Yeah, it's all over the news, so everybody's butting their nose in. Even the FBI wants a piece of the action.
Ah, Christ, now we got the feds on our back. I knew this was gonna be a shitty day. So what do we got?
Four androids. They knew the building, and they were very well organized. I'm still trying to figure out how they got this far without being noticed.
You checked the roof?
Not yet. There's so much to look at.
We have to make sure we check it out.
They attacked two guards in the hallway. Probably thought the androids were coming to do maintenance. They got taken down before they could react. The station employees managed to get away. He's in shock. Not sure when we'll be able to talk to him.
How many people were working here?
Just two employees and three androids. The deviants took the humans hostage and broadcast their message live. Then made their getaway from the roof.
The roof?
Yeah, they jumped with parachutes. We're still trying to figure out where they landed, but the weather's not helping. If you want to take a look at the video broadcast by the deviants, it's on that screen over there. Oh, Lieutenant, this is Special Agent Perkins from the FBI. Lieutenant Anderson is in charge of investigating for Detroit Police.
What's that?
My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
Androids investigating androids, huh? You sure you want an android hanging around? After everything that happened? Whatever. If the FBI would take over the investigation, you'd still be off the case.
Well, pleasure meeting you. Have a nice day.
And you watch your step. Don't fuck up my crap, Sam.
What a fucking prick.
I'll be nearby. If you need anything, just ask.
All right, well, let's have a look around. Let me know if you find anything.
Okay, Lieutenant.
We ask that you recognize our dignity our hopes and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
I think that's RA-9.
Deviants say RA-9 will set them free. This android seems to have that objective.
Something?
I identified its model and serial number.
Anything else I should know?
No. Nothing.
This is interesting. I think Connor's gonna turn good. He's gonna be a deviant too.
Made their way up through the whole building, past all the guards, and jumped off the roof with parachutes. Pretty fucking impressive, I'd say. How'd they manage to smuggle in a big bag like that?
They didn't. Someone brought it in for them.
Oh, that's strange. They planned a perfect operation but got the number of parachutes wrong.
Unless one of the deviants was left behind.
I know where he's gonna be. Now let's check this blood over here, shall we?
You have to stop them! If they destroy it, we won't learn anything!
We can't save it. It's too late. We'll just get ourselves killed.
You all right? Connor!
I'm okay.
Are you hurt?
I'm okay.
Jesus. Oh, you scared the shit out of me.
For fuck's sake, I told you not to move! Why do you never do what I say?
I was connected to its memory. When it fired, I felt it die. Like I was dying. I was scared. I saw something. In its memory. A word. Painted on a piece of rusty metal. Jericho.
Always doing that thing, Connor. Weirdo. Alright, let's exit. Hank, how are you? How are you, Hank?
Is everything okay, Lieutenant?
Chris was on patrol last night. He was attacked by a bunch of deviants.
Who?
Said he was saved by Marcus himself.
Is Chris okay?
Yeah, he's in shock, but he's alive. What the hell?
Turn your mind, Hank.
Kamsky left CyberLife 10 years ago. Why did you want to meet him?
This guy created the first android to pass the Turing test, and he's the founder of CyberLife. Anybody can tell us about deviants, it's him.
Oh, I get to meet my maker? Sweet. Oh, Lord, it's that bitch.
Hi.
I know that bitch.
I'm Lieutenant Hank Anderson, Detroit Police Department. I'm here to see Mr. Elijah Kamsky.
Please, come in.
The fucking main menu, bitch.
Okay.
Creeps me out.
I'll let Elijah know you're here, but please make yourself comfortable.
That's him.
Nice girl.
What's that?
You're right. She's really pretty. Amanda.
Nice place. Guess androids haven't been a bad thing for everybody. You're about to meet your maker, Connor. How's it feel?
Well,
I don't know. I'll tell you when I see him.
Sometimes I wish I could meet my creator face to face. I'd have a couple of things I'd want to tell him.
Which are? I can't say it. No, August, sit back down. He can't make up his mind. You know, just take it too long, you know. You know, I don't just see him. Oh. Shit.
Elijah, we'll see you now.
Mr. Holy Kamsky?
Crap, there's a lot of these girls.
Just a moment, please.
Oh, that's a dead end. Is that him? That's not him. What is him? Put your penis away.
I'm Lieutenant Anderson. This is Connor.
What can I do for you, Lieutenant?
Sir, we're investigating deviants. I know you left Cyberlife years ago, but I was hoping you'd be able to tell us something we don't know.
Oh, God. Long pause.
Deviants. Fascinating, aren't they? Perfect beings with infinite intelligence. Now they have free will. Machines are so superior to us. Confrontation was inevitable. Humanity's greatest achievement threatens to be its downfall. Isn't that ironic?
Something in the Deviant's program seems to emulate emotion. We thought you might know something about how that occurs.
All ideas of viruses spread like epidemics. Is the desire to be free a contagious disease?
Listen, I didn't come here to talk philosophy. The machines you created may be planning a revolution. Either you can tell us something that'll be helpful, or we will be on our way.
What about you, Connor? Whose side are you on?
I have no side. I was designed to stop deviants, and that's what I intend to do.
Well, that's what you're programmed to say. But you.
Uh-oh.
What do you really want?
What I want is not important.
I'm sure you're familiar with the Turing test. Your formality. Simple question of algorithms and computing capacity. What interests me is whether machines are capable of empathy. I call it the Kamsky test. It's very simple, you'll see.
What the fuck?
Magnificent, isn't it? One of the first intelligent models developed by CyberLife. Young and beautiful forever. A flower that will never wither. But what is it really? A piece of plastic containing a human? Or a living being? With a soul? It's up to you to answer that fascinating question, Connor. Destroy this machine, and I'll tell you all I know. Or spare it, if you feel it's alive. But you'll leave here without having learned anything from me.
Okay, I think we're done here. Come on, Connor, let's go. Sorry to get you
out of
here.
What's more important to you, Connor? Your investigation, or the life of this android? Decide who you are. An obedient machine. Or a living being endowed with free will.
That's enough. Connor, we're leaving.
Pull the trigger.
Connor! Don't!
And I'll tell you what you want to know.
I can't pull the trigger. I can't.
Cyberlife's last chance to save humanity is itself a deviant.
I'm not a deviant.
You prefer to spare a machine rather than accomplish your mission. You saw a living being in this android. You showed empathy. A war is coming. You'll have to choose your side. Will you betray your own people or stand up against your creators? What can be worse than having to choose between two evils?
Let's get out of here.
By the way, I always leave an emergency exit in my programs. You never know.
Self-destruct.
Why didn't you shoot?
I just saw that girl's eyes, and I couldn't. That's all.
You're always saying you would do anything to accomplish your mission. That was our chance to learn something, and you let it go.
Yeah, I know what I should have done. I told you I couldn't. I'm sorry, okay?
Well, maybe you did the right thing.
All right, Connor, let's go talk to Amanda. Never talk to her. She's different.
After what happened today, the country is on the verge of a civil war. The machines are rising up against their masters. Humans have no choice but to destroy them.
I thought Kamsky knew something. I was wrong.
Maybe he did. But you chose not to ask.
I saw a photo of Amanda at Kamsky's place. She was his teacher.
When Kamsky designed me, he wanted an interface that would look familiar. That's why he chose his former mentor. What are you getting at?
Where does CyberLife stand in all this? What do they really want?
All CyberLife wants is to resolve the situation and keep selling androids.
You didn't tell me everything you know about deviants, did you?
I expect you to find answers, Connor. Not ask questions. Have you experienced anything unusual recently? Any doubts or conflicts? Do you feel anything for these deviants? Or for Lieutenant Anderson?
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't feel anything. You know that. Are you suggesting that I've been compromised?
No. No, of course not.
You're off the case. The FBI is taking over.
What? But we're on to something. We just need more time, I'm sure we
can. Hank, you don't get it. This isn't just another investigation. It's a fucking civil war. It's out of our hands now. We're talking about national security here.
Fuck that. You can't just pull the plug now, not when we're so close.
You're always saying you can't stand androids. Jesus, Hank, make up your mind. I thought you'd be happy about this.
We're about to crack the case. I know we can solve it. For God's sake, Jeffrey, can't you back me up this one time?
There's nothing I can do. You're back on homicide, and the android returns to cyberlife. I'm sorry, Hank, but it's over.
All right, let's go talk to Hank.
We can't just give up like that. I know we could have solved this case.
So you're going back to Cyberlife?
No.
I have no choice. I'll be deactivated and analyzed to find out why I failed.
What if we're on the wrong side, Connor? What if we're fighting against people who just want to be free?
I know we're on the right side. Humans created us. They're our masters. No machine should rebel against its creator.
When you refuse to kill that android at Kamsky's place, you put yourself in her shoes. You showed empathy, Connor. Empathy's a human emotion.
Yeah, he's right.
I don't know why I did it. I'm not programmed to say things like this, but I really appreciated working with you. With a little more time, who knows? We might have even become friends.
Well, well, here comes Perkins, that motherfucker. Sure don't waste any time at the FBI.
We can't give up. I know the answers and the evidence we collected. If Perkins takes it, it's all over.
There's no choice. You heard Fowler. We're off the case.
You've got to help me, Lieutenant. I need more time so I can find a lead in the evidence we collected. I know the solution is in there.
Listen, Connor.
If I don't solve this case, Cyberlife will destroy me. 5 minutes. That's all I ask.
Key to the basement is on my desk. Get a move on. I can't distract him forever.
Hey, Connor. I'm talking to you, asshole. Where are you going? Wouldn't any plastic pricks around here, or did anybody tell you? Hey, asshole, I'm talking to you.
Come on, hurry up.
Hank's password. What would a hard-boiled, eccentric police lieutenant choose? Ridiculous. No one would have a password like that.
Date of birth.
Stupid idea. It's not Hankish enough.
This one is.
Obviously. Is Jericho. The answer's here somewhere. How much time? Gotta think fast. The deviant who took a child hostage.
This guy.
The android that murdered its owner. One of the deviants that hacked the TV station with Marcus. It must have known where the deviants are hiding.
It's dark. Where am I?
I'm a deviant. Like you. I need your help. I want to go to Jericho.
I don't recognize your voice. You're not one of us. I'll never tell you where Jericho is. Now leave me alone.
Seven, five, five.
Stop a disaster, but you have to tell me where Jericho is.
I remember you. We could have escaped. Been free. But you killed us. Disconnect me. I'd rather be dead than live without her.
Thank you. 4717. This could be bad.
This since the first second I saw you.
Don't do it, Gavin. I know how to stop the deviants.
You're off the case. And now, it's gonna be definitive.
Come on. Fight me. Bitch!
What happened here? Looks like someone's been snooping around.
Oh shit! Get the alarm! Now!